on the Darjeeling Narrow Gauge Railway, but is a rarity on the Canadian National. Two members of the train crew go ahead of the engines, sanding the rail by hand. The locomotive sanders are not working. These engines are pulling as hard as they can. The driving wheels are slipping on the rail.
Thank you.
the train cannot run on the abandoned track after dark. The absence of flashing warning lights at highway crossings makes after dark operation too hazardous. There is too much risk of a motorist driving into the side of the train. The train is parked for the night at the Long Hill Road crossing near Mahone Bay. Martin's River Bridge. Crossing Highway Number 3 at Martin's River. Crossing Highway Number 3 at Martin's Point. Crossing the Lawrence Hat Road in Western Shore. the Station Road crossing in Western Shore. The train crew will use the siding here to switch the van to the rear of the train. The operating rules require that this be done before leaving the abandoned track at East River. The bridge over the Gold River. The train stops to flag the Croft Road crossing. the Croft Road crossing, Chester Basin. The train stops to flag highway number 12. Highway number 12. Highway number 3, Marriott's Cove. Marriott's Cove Road. The quiet running with no rail squeal is due to the wet rail. The crackling sound is the effect of the heavy rain. The train crew is again out in front, sanding the rail by hand. This steep uphill grade in Chester, combined with the wet rail, is making it difficult for the locomotives to pull the train. It is perilously close to stalling.